I imagine this could be a chromosome. It's a decondensed structure, but in metaphase, this structure has to become much smaller. It has to be about this big. So how do cells do this? So what happens is that during early steps of mitosis, during prophase, this long, long chromosome is really, really long. In the first round of folding, becomes much shorter through a process by which a machine will land on the DNA and extrude a loop. And it will do it over and over again all along this chromosome. And as it does that, the chromosome gets shorter and shorter. So now you have a series of loops, and the chromosome gets shorter and shorter. As it does that, these loops get really, really big at some point, and it makes the chromosome short, but way too wide. So in a second round of folding, the same machine, or the same type of machine, will land inside the loop and repeat this process and basically split each loop in smaller loops. So now we have a series of small loops all along the chromosome. This leads to lots and lots of loops along this long chromosome, and serically this becomes problematic, and in order for the chromosome to get even shorter, these loops start rotating helically around the long axis of this chromosome, allowing this chromosome to become even shorter. So as a result, we end up with this long array of loops, where loops are rotating around this central axis, a little bit like the steps around a spiraling staircase. And this allows the cell to start with this very long chromosome and end up with this very tightly packed array of loops that facilitates the segregation to daughter cells.